Blackstone Audio presents Flying Colors, the story of a remarkable group of artists and the transcendent power of art, by Tim Lefens. This book is read by Grover Gardner. Dedication for Anne Bannister. Flying Colors. When you get to the top of the hill, there are two ways to go. Straight, which will take you into the woods, and left, which will take you to the hospital. I'd been told it was a school. The car slows to a crawl past the fancy wooden sign. It seemed like a nice enough thing, an abstract painter being invited to a school. But I, like you, am not anxious to go into a hospital, no matter what the reason. The last acres of rising fields behind me now, the building appears. Low, one-story, brick. It sits up on the top of this high hill, alone. Quaint little towns and farmlands in the valley far below. A cardboard box under each arm, I wait outside the automatic glass doors of the main entrance. With a pneumatic exhale, the door rumbles open, and I step into the building. The receptionist is on the phone. When she gets off, she places a piece of paper and a blank ID badge on the counter, pushes them toward me. "Fill these out," she says, then turns back to her work. Clipping the blank ID badge to my shirt, I hoist my slide projector and portable screen. Halfway down the main hall, fluorescent lights, gloss white cinder block walls, shining linoleum floor. I have to step quickly to my right. Three doctors in white lab coats sweep past, behind them a child on a stretcher. The doctors, the child, and the man pushing the stretcher make a hard right turn and disappear. The kid had not been on the stretcher the normal way. The stretcher had been rigged so it stood vertically, pushed ahead on a set of four wheels, the child lashed to the stretcher by a wide nylon belt that ran across his chest, up under his armpits, the little arms extending out and away from his body, fingers splayed, eyes glazed, tiny feet hanging above the rushing floor. My stomach tightens. Further down the hall, two women stand together. A third, younger, sits in a wheelchair. As I move past them, I hear their conversation. "You're going to see a movie today." One of the standing women speaks sing-song to the woman sitting in the wheelchair. "A movie? Yes, you are. Do you like movies?" The young woman in the wheelchair stares vacantly at the floor. "Anyway, like I was saying," the standing woman turns to her co-worker, "I am definitely getting that place down the shore this year." Well past the women, I am drawn, for some reason, to stop, to look back. And I am startled to see the young woman in the wheelchair watching me. She smiles, her eyes warm with the pleasure that we, at least our eyes, have met. Turning away, I blink. One moment the young woman looks brain dead, the next completely alive. A little lightheaded, the experience becoming surreal, I order my legs to move. At the end of the hall, a set of glass doors with a warning. "Emergency exit only. Alarm will sound. Salida de emergencia solamente. Alarma funcionara." To the right of the fire door alcove, a short unlit corridor. At the end of the corridor, an open door. I look back at the landscape outside the emergency exit, then turn to step into the dark. In the center of the room sits a person, his head held upright by a network of stainless steel wires that run like spokes from a metallic headband to aluminum armatures bolted to the back of the wheelchair. His underdeveloped body sits rigid, symmetrical as the chrome wheelchair. His brittle stick arms are strapped to the vinyl-padded armrests, his hands dangling off the ends, the fingers twisted, bent backward, welded into knots. From the immobilized head, his eyes meet mine. A burst of voltage passes from him, through his eyes to me. Totally disarmed by the force of this contact, I look away. Disoriented, my eyes dart nervously around the room. A recessed window. On its sill, mounds of objects made from chunks of torn styrofoam.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.